Welcome to the Best Practice Podcast. This is Bastian Best, and today we are gonna look at how to patent database technology in Europe. So why this topic today? Well, basically for two reasons. The first reason is that in my patent attorney practice, I'm dealing quite a lot with inventions in the field of database technology, so I have kind of a personal connection to that topic. But secondly, and that's the actual current reason, is that there will be an update to the guidelines for examination in the European Patent Office. And this update will now include a new section on database management technology. In case you've been watching this podcast, you will have heard that the guidelines are updated almost every year. So 2 years ago, a section on AI and machine learning was introduced. I talked about that in episode number one. And now today we are going to look at the new upcoming a new section on database management technology. Okay. Before we dive in, some housekeeping notes. So this topic was actually not my idea, but it was brought up by one of my YouTube viewers, Alexander Schult. Thank you very much for the topic suggestion. If you, any one of you, my listeners and my viewers, if you have topic suggestions, topics I should address in this podcast, please let me know, as far as it is somehow related to digital patents, digital inventions, and computer-implemented software-based inventions and how to patent them in Europe and beyond. So you can send me those suggestions via the YouTube comments, on LinkedIn, by email, whatever. Just let me know. I'm doing this for you, after all. There were some listener slash viewer questions concerning the last episode, where I was talking about the case law of the Boards of Appeal about AI-related inventions. And we have one question from Marie Barani. I think you are French, so I hope this is the right pronunciation. I go with Marie. I hope that's okay. And the question was, do you think that if the spam filter claims had been drafted differently, it could have been considered as technical if the content of the email were not the decision key to label the email? So this question goes back to an example I was giving of a Board of Appeal decision concerning a spam filter, an AI-based spam filter. And the Board of Appeal decided that in this case, there was no technical contribution, because the way how the spam filter decides whether a given email is spam or legitimate email is based purely on the content of the email, the textual content, and the board was of the opinion that this was a linguistic differentiation, not a technical one, so no patent in the end here. Now Marie asks whether this patent application could have had a different fate if the claims would have been drafted differently. Well, yes, absolutely. It all depended on what was the criterion for deciding whether the email is spam or not. And if the invention would have been about a clearly technical criterion of an email has technical characteristics, of course. It has a file size, it has a certain encoding format. So if those would have been the subject of the spam filter, let's say if the spam filter would have said, well, every time, I'm just making that up now, every time the email has a certain type of data encoding, which is kind of exotic, and there is an attachment greater than 1 megabyte, then there's a likelihood that this is spam. I think that would have been technical criteria, and those would then have entered the inventive step assessment. So, hope this answers your question. In the end, yeah, this is a quite an interesting case, because it serves for a lot of discussion about what should still be considered technical and what not. The boards take quite a clear stance that every time you look at content of data, the cognitive content, so to say, that's non-technical. And we will actually see that again in the database realm later on. A second question was from Alex Mungai on LinkedIn. And he asks, what exactly do you claim in a database patent? Looking at today's topic. The structure of the schemas, the method of aggregating data objects from different schemas? Great question. Generally speaking, patents protect technical inventions, right? Or let's say things that are conceptually different from what is already known. Now, a new database schema as such does probably not conceptually change how the database operates. Let me make an example. So if you have, let's say, a flight ticket reservation system, you know, a database, and the known database from the prior art has a schema with a flight number, date, and time. Very simple example. Now, if the new database schema also has, let's say, flight number, date, and time, and also the meal choice of the passenger, for example. That's a different schema, but that would not be a technical invention, because it's just about the content of the database, and it's not a conceptual difference which has any technical impact. It's not a technical invention, I would say, unless the new schema has an impact on the technical performance of the database system. So, for example, think about a database index. That's a different story. Database index is that's not really about the content, about how to organize the content in a meaningful manner, but it has technical reasons why an index is structured as it is structured. We will see that later on when we dive into the new chapter we will be talking about today. Long story short, to summarize, patents for database technology are mostly more about novel ways of how a database management system operates and less about the concrete contents in the database. Okay, so hope this answers your question. There was one other question concerning the first two podcast episodes about AI and machine learning from Simon van Mierlo. Good questions, very difficult questions, I must say, and the most recent one was about the topics of technical purpose versus technical character. So this is really an elaborated topic, and I would like to postpone that, Simon, maybe even for its own podcast episode, because it's a big topic. Okay, with that being said, let's dive into today's actual topic, which is the new section in the guidelines for examination in the European Patent Office. As I said, the guidelines this update to the guidelines will enter into force on March 1st, 2020, in 2 weeks. And what is available online right now, what we will be looking at here, is called the unedited English version for advance information. So it's officially still a draft, but I don't expect that there will be any substantial changes. When we will be going through that new section, the basic question always is the domain we are looking at, here it is, database technology, is the domain considered technical or not by the EPO? Because as you will know if you are following me for some time, according to the EPO, if the invention has a mix of technical and non-technical subject matter, according to the COMBIC approach, which is the established approach for assessing inventive step of mixed type inventions, according to the COMBIC approach, only that part of the invention that contributes to the technical character of the invention, only that part which solves a technical problem, that enters into the examination of inventive step, and the non-technical part does not. It is just given to the skilled person as a requirements specification. To give some background, some context, but the technical problem must always be technical, and yeah, only the technical features of the invention enter into the examination of inventive step. Then, so the basic question is always: is something technical or not? And hopefully, the new chapter sheds some light on the topic of database management systems. The chapter is the section is called Database Management Systems and Information Retrieval. So there are two topics combined. Before we dive into the section now, finally, let's take one step back and let's briefly look at the section preceding the new one, that is section 3.6.3, which is called Data Retrieval Formats and Structures. So already here we have a topical overlap, I would say, to some extent. And this new chapter says in one place, I'm citing now, similarly, an index structure used for searching a record in a database produces a technical effect since it controls the way the computer performs the search operation. And there is a certain Board of Appeal decision cited. So here it already clearly says that index structures in a database produce a technical effect. So those are pretty safe from a patentability standpoint. And yeah, I also had quite a number of European patents granted on novel index structures, which is for people who do not regularly deal with software-based inventions, kind of exotic maybe. The claim one was really about a database index comprising and then the structure of the index. So it was really about a data format, a data structure. Normally in computer-implemented inventions, most of the time what you have is a method claim as claim one. So claim one is mostly directed to a computer implemented method, and then you have the different steps that make up the novel algorithm which you want to patent. But in this case, in the case of a database index, of course the invention is more has a more static character, and therefore you can have a claim directed to an index structure, and this solves a technical problem. It produces a technical effect, as the guidelines say here. Now, the actual section we are talking about today is part G of the guidelines, patentability, chapter 2, section 3.6.4, called Database Management Systems and Information Retrieval. It has roughly 1.5 pages of text, so I will certainly not read everything today, but let's go through the key passages. So already in the first sentence it says, and I'm now citing, database management systems are technical systems implemented on computers to perform the technical tasks of storing and retrieving data using various data structures for efficient management of data. A method performed in a database management system is thus a method which uses technical means and is therefore not excluded from patentability. Okay, so what does this say in detail? Let's unpack this. So first of all, a nice statement for any database developer looking to patent the inventions is that the guidelines now clearly say that storing and retrieving data using data structures for efficient management of data, that is a technical task. It's called a technical task. And it also makes it clear that a database management system is a technical system. That wasn't so clear beforehand. I remember one case. I was at the examining division in an oral proceedings at the end of the examination phase. I think it was in Berlin. And we were arguing about an invention in database technology, and at some point the examiner even made the argument that a database management system need not be technical in the first place, because he said that well, a database is in the end just an organized collection of information. So, for example, a bookshelf is also a database in that sense. And a management system need not be a technical computer system, but it could also be a, let's say, conceptual system for organizing the books. So, and then in the end, that was his argument, a database management system could be purely a recipe how the librarian organizes his books in the library. Now, this argument cannot reasonably be made anymore, because now the guidelines pretty clearly say that database management systems are technical systems. So that's a good thing, I would say. The guidelines also go on and talk about improving system throughput and query response times, and more generally, if features specifying the internal functioning of the database management system, if those are concerned, those are normally based on technical considerations. That was also a citation from the guidelines. So, and therefore also such features enter into the inventive step assessment. There are two positive Board of Appeal decisions cited in this context in the new guidelines section. And coincidentally, both of these decisions are already discussed on EuropeanSoftwarePatents.com, our little database of Board of Appeal case law concerning software-based inventions. I will put links to those articles on EuropeanSoftwarePatents.com into the show notes and into the YouTube description. Anyway, also I will of course put a link to the draft of the new guideline section into the show notes, right? The guidelines then go on and state that, I'm citing again, optimizing the execution of structured queries with respect to computer resources needed, such as CPU, main memory, or hard disk, contributes to the technical character of the invention. This is an interesting statement because, well, optimizing the execution of structured queries is a big topic in database management, and there are inventions every day made about how to optimize the query processing. Here the guidelines make an interesting distinction in this half sentence, because they say that what contributes to the technical character of the invention is optimizing the execution of such structured queries with respect to computer resources needed, for example, CPU, main memory, or hard disk. Little story, I had quite a number of patent applications for a database developing client, and if you do query processing, and normally what you do in a database is you receive the query from the user in a structured format, for example, an SQL query, right? And then it is parsed into a tree data structure. You can transfer any SQL query into a logical tree, and then you get a logical query plan, which only says on the level of relational algebra how to process the SQL query. And you can optimize that logical query plan quite a bit and quite cleverly so that it can eventually be executed faster. Now, the logical query plan is not directly executed, but it is, when it was optimized, it is then transferred into a physical query plan, and only the physical query plan then really says has more the algorithmic recipe for executing the query. So the physical query plan really says which index to access and what to do then, how to join intermediate results and things like that. So only here we really get into the retrieving and storing of information. Now, in my case, in my client's case, the inventions were in many cases about optimizing the logical query plan, which has great impact on the overall performance, because the remaining steps are then all more efficient. But the EPO examiners always said that that's not a technical effect, because in database technology, there is, let's say, it's a layered architecture, and it's there for a purpose. The logical query plan and the physical query plan both encapsulate their respective domains, let's say. So if you optimize on the logical level, so the examiners, this does not, this is an algorithmic optimization. It might have algorithmic improved efficiency, but it does not necessarily result in a physical better performance. So the question remains here: should logical query optimization be patentable? At least from the section I was reading right now, the section really talks about optimizing query processing with respect to the computer resources needed. So this is really quite hardware-based still. But there is the next sentence in the new guidelines, which says, and I'm citing again, data structures such as an index, hash table, or a query tree used in database management systems to facilitate access to data or for the execution of structured queries contribute to the technical character of the invention. So for me, this is a great statement, because it says that, for example, an index is technical data. We already talked about it, but it also mentions a hash table, okay, and a query tree. So it really says a query tree used in database management systems to facilitate access to data contributes to the technical character of the invention. And if you know a thing or two about database management technology, a query tree, that's typically a highly abstracted conceptual view of, let's say, the relational algebra underlying the database management system. So, and if that is technical, also an optimized logical query plan should be technical, in my opinion. But maybe there's some room for discussion at this point. I'm looking forward. I'm excited about how the patent examiners will use this part of the new section in the guidelines. Okay, then we let's go on. There's then a distinction made between structured queries, for example, SQL. We talked about that. And on the other hand, information retrieval. For example, and what is meant here in the guidelines with information retrieval is more the idea when you, for example, input free text into a search engine, so that it's not about database management systems where you have structured queries, but you have unstructured free text queries in a search engine, for example. So here the guidelines say, I'm citing again, if the method of estimating relevance or similarity relies solely on non-technical considerations, such as the cognitive content of the items to be retrieved, purely linguistic rules, or other subjective criteria. For example, items found relevant by friends in social networks, it does not make a technical contribution. So, here again, the EPO doesn't like it when the content of the data, the content of the actual text, is taken into account as a criterion to do something. This is, as I said in the beginning, similar to the AI-based spam filter. So if you have a search engine, the user types in a certain keyword he is looking for, and if the idea is now, the invention is to look for semantically similar search results, and then something like that would not be considered technical, because it's again about the cognitive content of the information and not any hard technical criteria. It also gives an example in the new guidelines. It says, for example, a mathematical model for calculating the probability that a given term is similar in meaning to another term by analyzing the co-occurrence frequency of the two terms in a collection of documents does not make a technical contribution per se, since it is based on considerations of a purely linguistic nature. That means based on the assumption that terms which are related are more likely than unrelated terms to occur in the same documents. So, as I just said, if you have complicated mathematical models which in the end calculate the probability that two text terms are similar, that is considered just a linguistic aspect by the EPO, not a technical one. And then the guidelines say, in this context of retrieval based on similarity of meaning of terms, the concept of better search is subjective. And there's a Board of Appeal decision cited here. So the argument in this case, in this appeal case, was that the way how the search engine works by comparing similar terms results in a better search, in better search results. And the boards here have said, and this is now adopted into the guidelines, well, better search is subjective. What is better? It's subject to what the user likes or not, but that's not an objective technical criterion. In contrast, optimizing the execution time of structured queries in a database management system, as discussed above, is a technical effect. That's another citation from the guidelines. So, and that's it. Basically, that's the new section about database management technology and information retrieval. So, to wrap it up, so what are the key takeaways? Well, on the one hand, first of all, I like the new section. It's not very surprising what's in there. I mean, it's, and it shouldn't, because as far as I understand, the guidelines are not really there to define a new direction for where the examiners should go, but the guidelines really only codify what is already, what should be common practice at the office and at the boards of appeal. So I would say the new section pretty nicely summarizes the current practice of the EPO. I think we can say as a bottom line that improvements in database management technology are rather on the technical side, so those are rather on the safe side when it comes to filing patents, at least as long as the invention is about really improving the performance of the database, the way improving the way the database operates. And if that problem is solved by the invention, you can claim a new data structure, a new database index, static aspects, and also dynamic aspects like new algorithms, new ways of searching a database. And so from the technicality point of view, I think this is a rather safe field. In contrast, a better search of information retrieval, so a better search engine, is certainly more difficult to patent, because here the distinction between technical criteria for improving the search and subjective criteria is more difficult to do. As I said, new data structures, index structures are technical, new ways of processing queries are technical as far as they concern the internal functioning of the database management system. So all in all, I would say it's good to have the new section. It gives a good summary about how the EPO deals with this field of technology. As I said, I will put a link into the draft guideline section into the show notes and into the YouTube description. The new section will come into force in 2 weeks on March 1st, 2020. So, I hope you found value in this episode. If so, please make sure you subscribe to the podcast in your favorite podcasting app and or subscribe to the YouTube channel so that you don't miss the next episode. And then please do me a favor and tell your friends and colleagues about this podcast. This is still a new project. It's only the third episode here, so I would really appreciate if you help me promote my work here. And finally, let me know how you found this information and what you want me to cover next. So I'm always open to topic suggestions. Just let me know in the YouTube comments, send me a message, just let me know. Okay, so that's it for today. Thanks for listening and talk to you soon.